Well, good afternoon, y'all. I'm extremely pleased to join the bipartisan leadership of the Alabama legislature today for a bill signing ceremony for the prison construction bill package that moved through their respective houses this week. Folks, this is a pivotal moment for the trajectory of our state's criminal justice system. For several years now, we have worked to address Alabama's long-standing prison infrastructure challenges. These challenges were decades in the making, and while we worked diligently to resolve them, it took a lot of hard work and a lot of positive conversations between both sides of the aisle to get to today. Currently, our state is under more than 15 separate federal mandates regarding the prison conditions of our prisons. And as a result of those mandates, in the last 5 years, 85 cents of every additional dollar that has been allocated to ADOC's budget is tied to address these mandates. Anyone of us balancing a checkbook at our homes knows there's no way to budget when 85% of your funding is tied up. Achieving an Alabama solution to our problems rather than a federal ordered court mandate was paramount. And y'all, that's what happened today and this week. Addressing these challenges through the construction of new prison facilities is the legal and fiscally sound thing for us to do. And it's also morally the right thing to do to ensure we have safe working conditions for our correction staff and proper rehabilitation capabilities for the inmates. Since early this summer, my team and I have had many meetings with the legislature to dig into the issues and get to the facts. And as a result, a solid legislative proposal was developed, and every effort was made to inform all 140 members of the legislature and answer as many remaining questions as possible. Let me be clear, while more reform of the system can and does need to be addressed in the future, I am committed to that as our many legislators. Today's bill signing on the construction part of this issue is a major step forward. Y'all, I want to point out that this rose here on the desk where we'll soon sign the bill is a red rose that was given to me by two inmates who had completed the welding program at Ingram State Technical College up in Dietzville when I visited several prisons last year. As many of you know, Alabama has the only community college of its kind in the country where people who have paid their dues to society and are about to be released from prison can go and learn a trade, becoming a welder, a chef, an electrician, a truck driver, or some other respectable needed profession. I cannot say enough good things about the men and women of the legislature, and especially these leaders who are with me today, who worked tirelessly through the summer to develop this legislation and then help shepherd it through this special session. I'd like to personally offer my thanks to the legislative leadership who are all standing behind me right here for a successful special session and to what we believe will yield untold benefits to all Alabamians in the days ahead. To a person, legislative leaders, you were dedicated and focused, all the while remaining cordial and respectful with opposing viewpoints that were made in the heat of debate. As a result, this legislation received bipartisan support to help address a problem that has plagued our state for decades and for generations. We all know that addressing this issue has not been easy, but sometimes doing the right thing and the hard thing are one and the same. This bill signing ceremony today shows that by working together, there is absolutely nothing we cannot achieve on behalf of the hardworking, good people of Alabama. Chairman Klaus, sponsor of the bill, you're recognized.
Thank you, Governor, and thank you for the help from you and your staff. The last 4 months since we left the regular session, there have been continuous meetings with all of these folks behind me, weekly in-person meetings, Zoom calls, conference calls. This was a culmination of a lot of hard work with the issue that has really dogged us probably for the last 5 years. As I said on the floor on Wednesday, this is a win-win-win situation for the state of Alabama. It's a win from the financial aspect on the amount of cash that we're putting forward that's going to save on interest payments for us to put into renovations as we go into phase two. It's a win by getting us on down the road to be in compliance with the Department of Justice. And the most important win is the public safety aspects, not only for us, but for our children and grandchildren for generations to come, to provide them a safe place to live in the state of Alabama and make sure that they're safe from violent prisoners. So I just, again, thank you, Governor, for your leadership and leading us in this effort.
We have an order here, and I've been told I'm next. Alabama's always been a great place to live. Born and raised here, it's always been home. And today, Alabama's even better. We've had our challenges and problems. We've had our difficulties. We've had our fights. But today, we've risen above that. We have attacked a problem, and we've solved it with this. We're a little bit better. Thanks to the governor, and she's right, this was the right thing to do, morally and otherwise. The leadership that we have here have come together, overcome all kinds of challenges, even including personalities, in some cases, but we have overcome them all to come to a point and a solution. I'm proud to be a part of them. I'm proud to be a part of this body. I'm proud of Alabama.
Well, Governor, you made a statement probably maybe a little over a year ago when we really saw the real issue that was coming before us when it came to our correction system, and you said this is an Alabama problem that needs an Alabama solution. And I want to salute you today because with the legislative help and the work that we've done, we've got a solution to an Alabama problem. It takes leadership to stand up and sometimes just make the first step. I'm like Chairman Albritton. I'm very proud of the Alabama legislature today. Mr. Pro Tem, Senate members, Senate leadership, thank you for your work. House members that are here with us today, I'm thankful for the House members. As I sit in the chair in the House chamber and I watch the members work the floor and work those issues, and Chairman Klaus was working that bill on the floor. It was coming together for a common need and a solution to a problem that we have experienced, not just for the last couple of years, but for decades. And this is a very proud day for Alabama. We have taken a step to fix a problem that has not been addressed as it should be for years. We've got a savings plan in place. We've got money to move us forward to protect our inmates and our correction staff, safety, health, all of the concerns that we've worked on. And I just want to say how very, very proud I am just to be a part of something like this today. It's a proud moment for Alabama. And Governor and Mr. Pro Tem, Senate members, House members, I want to say really thank you for your work. Great work.
Governor, thank you for the opportunity to be here today. As the President of the State Senate, I'm proud of my colleagues. I'm proud of the legislature in the state of Alabama. I appreciate so much your staff and the effort that you put forward personally in giving us an opportunity to move forward this way. Ladies and gentlemen, what you're witnessing is an opportunity for Republicans, Democrats, the House, the Senate, the governor's administration, for the benefit of the people of Alabama at a time such as this, to come together with collaboration and have a positive outcome that puts us on a trajectory of an opportunity for success as we deal with this decades-old problem. I just want to thank the two gentlemen that carried the bills in the House, Chairman Klaus, Chairman Albritton in the Senate. I want to thank my friend, Speaker McCutcheon. We've talked 100 times on the telephone about the pathway of this process. All of the House and Senate members and Governor, certainly you and your staff, it is a fine day for Alabama, ma'am, and I'm glad to be a part of it. Thank you so much. God bless you.
Y'all want the mic or not? Will anyone else be saying anything? Okay, I'll get it out of the way.